1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I call out your number, I'll tell you where you're going to be in the formation.
Oh, God, I've got my number!
Right. I find the number without a person, it's you. Okay, girls first. Number 2, downstage. Number 9, upstage. Number 10, downstage. And number 23, upstage. Number 23, Judy Turner.
Oh, 23!
Stage left, girls. Second group, number 37, downstage. Number 60, upstage.
Thank you.
count. When I call out your number, please form a line. Girls first. Number two. Number nine. Number 10. Number 23, Judy Turner.
23!
Five. Number 37.
Oh.
149. 152. 179. 17. Other girls, thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry. Boys, number 17, number 44, 45, 63, 67, 81, and 84. Other boys, thank you. Larry?
Today I want you to tell me your stage name, real name if it's different, and I'd also like to know where you were born and when.
Terrific.
Fabulous.
Oh, excuse me, sir! Do we have to? I mean, it's not very polite to have to leave your age.
Being polite doesn't interest me. Your age does, and I want to know your age. Okay, let's go down the line. We'll start on the end. Stage, right.
Maggie Winslow.
Louder.
Costa Filoni. Born Trenton, New Jersey, July 9, 1960. But that makes me 25.
Next.
Connie Wong. It's always been Connie Wong. I was born in Chinatown, Lower East Side.
Your age?
Go on, Miss Wong.
December 5, 4,642, the year of the chicken.
Next.
My real name is Sidney Kenneth Beckenstein. My Jewish name is Rachmil Eben Yochav Meyer Beckenstein. And my professional name, Gregory Gardner. Very East Side, and I do not deny it. Born August 2nd, 1958.
Kathy. Zach, can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, go ahead.
Well, I mean privately.
Not right now, Cassie. I'm running about an hour behind.
Well, I know, but I want to
talk
to you.
Next.
I'm Sheila Bryant. Really, Sarah Rosemary Bryant, which I really hate. I was born December 7th, 1957, in Colorado Springs, Colorado. And I'm going to be 30 real soon.
Oh,
I'm Robert Charles Joseph Henry Mills III. That's my real name, too. I come from upstate New York near Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town. I blocked it out. Born March 15, 1960.
My name is Bebe Bensonheimer! Oh, no, no, I gotta change it. Born 2-6, 1959. I come from Boston and, well, here I am!
My name is Judy Turner. But my real name is Lana Turner.
Good. Next.
My name is Richie Walters. I'm from Herculaneum, Missouri. I was born on a full moon, June 13th, 1958. And I'm black.
Ralph DeLuca. Born January 11th, 1960. I come from the Bronx.
I'm Christine Urich. Christine Evelyn Urich. Born September 1st, 1963.
Where are you from?
Oh, I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. Oh, and my married name is DeLuca.
Oh, I didn't know, Al. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Next.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'm Valerie Clark. But my parents seem to think I'm Margaret Mary Houlihan. Couldn't you just die? I'm from the middle of nowhere, a little town called Arlington, Vermont. Bye-bye.
How old are you?
Oh. No, really? 25.
Mark Anthony, really Mark Philip Lawrence Savory, Tempe, Arizona, I'm 20.
Jesus.
And if I get this show, I'll work real hard.
Brother.
Don't let him find you, honey.
I'm Paul San Marco. That's my stage name. My real name is Hector Ramirez. I was born in Spanish Harlem, October 22nd, 1959.
My name is Diana Morales, and I didn't change it because I figured ethnic was in. 6-10-61, you got that? And I was born in a Hollywood bed in the Bronx.
Go on, Diana.
Go on what? Oh, do you want to know how tall I am? Or the color of my eyes? Or how many shows I've done? I just gave you my picture and resume. Everything you want to know is right there.
I know. Now tell me what's not on it.
Like what?
Talk about yourself.
Talk about what?
Tell me about the Bronx.
Instead of tell about the Bronx, step down to the right.
What did you do there?
In the Bronx? Mostly wait to get out.
What made you start dancing?
Who knows? I have rhythm. I'm Puerto Rican. I always jump around to dance. Do you want to see if I can act? Well, can you see to read? I'll act on the floor. I can't just talk. Please. I'm too nervous.
Then relax.
Look, I don't mind talking, really, but I just can't be the first. Please.
You want the job, don't you?
Sure, I want the job.
All right, Deanna. Back in line. Before we do any more dancing, and we will be dancing some more, let me explain something. I'm looking for a strong dancing chorus. I need people that look terrific together and that can work together as a group. But there are some small parts that have to be played by the dancers I hire. Now I have your pictures and resumes. I know what shows you've been in, but that's not going to help me. And I don't want to give you just a few lines to read. I think it would be better if I knew something about you, about your personalities. So I'm going to ask you some questions. I want to hear you talk. Treat it like an interview. I don't want you to think you have to perform. I just want to hear you talk and be yourselves. And everybody just relax as much as you can. Sheila?
How many people do you want?
Four and four.
44?
No, four and four.
Four boys, four girls.
Need any women?
Okay, Mike, I'll start with you.
Me? Well, don't you want to start at the end?
No, I'll start with you. And relax.
could if you started at the end. What do you want to know?
What do you want to tell me?
I'd like to tell you to start at the end. I can't think of a thing.
Yes, you can. Why did you start dancing?
Well, because my sister did. Well, I come from this big Italian family. My grandmother, well, she was always hanging out the window, leaning on a little pillow. Because that's what Italian grandmothers do, they hang out windows. I was the last of 12. Oh, and I was an accident.
Oh, sure.
Well, I was. Well, that's what my sister told me. Oh, well, that was his sister, Rosalie. She's the one who started taking the dance lessons. My mother used to take her every Saturday. And she'd take me along. But I like going.
How old were you?
4. And I'd sit there all perky and I'm watching Sis go pit a pat. Said, I can do that. I can do that. Do every step right off the bat. Said, I can do that. I can do that. One modern Sis won't go to dance class. I grabbed her shoes and tights and all.
Getting strange.
love to go down to this busy intersection near my house at rush hour. And direct traffic. I just wanted to see if anybody noticed me. That's when I started breaking into people's houses. Oh, I wouldn't steal anything. I just rearranged the furniture. Oh, and...
orphan at three, mother and dad both gone, raised by sweet Ed Conn, tied up and raped at seven, seriously, chubby to a flea, I better keep it clean.
What should I say? What can I tell him?
School? You want to hear about school? Well, I went to P.S. Shit. See, I was the kind of kid that was always getting slammed in the lockers and stuff like that. Well, not only by the students, by the teachers, too. Oh, and I hated sports. I hated sports. And sports were very big.
I mean, it was just
I make one team. See, I couldn't catch a ball if it had Elmer's glue on it. And wouldn't my father have to be this big ex-football hero? Well, he was so humiliated, he didn't know what to tell his friends. So he told them all I had polio. On Father's Day, I used to live for him.
And try to be calm, try to be calm. You're getting overwrought. Follow a train of thought. That way you won't be nervous. Try to relax, try to relax. Only laugh a while. I'll close my eyes and smile.
Saying, if you don't stop setting your little brother on fire, we're going to have to send you away. And I kept thinking of these spectacular ways of how to kill myself. But then I realized, to commit suicide in Buffalo is redundant.
Sheila?
Yes? You want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
To talk.
Right. What do you want to know about me first?
Try, why are you in this business?
Well, I wanted to be this dream about a... Oh, light. What color is that? Do you have anything softer?
Don't worry about the lights. Just talk.
Well, like I said, I wanted to be a ballerina because my mother was a ballerina. So my father made her.
Sheila, come downstage. Closer.
Can I sit on your lap?
Do you always come on like this?
No, sometimes I'm a Griff. Actually, I'm a Leo.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means the other 11 months of the year better watch out. I'm very strong.
Maybe too strong.
Did I say something you don't like? I mean, you told me to be myself.
Just bring it down.
Bring what down?
Your attitude. Tell me about your parents.
Parents?
Your father.
Him?
Your mother.
My mother. My mother was raised like a little nun. But she couldn't go out. She couldn't even babysit.
Sheila, don't perform. Just talk.
She wanted to be a dancer and she had all the fun. She was all that married my father and made her give it up. And then she had this daughter, me. Well, she made her what she wanted to be. And she was fabulous the way she did it. You want to know how she did it?
Yes, but first your hair.
You don't like it?
No. Let it down.
That's what I've been trying to do.
Better. Go on.
How she did it? Well, first she took me to all the ballets. Then she gave me her old toe. She'd nice run down the block on my toes at age five. Then I saw the red shoes. Well, I wanted to be that lady, redhead. She saw I had to dance. She said, well, you can't start until you're eight. But then I was only 16.
What? What did you say?
I just said I wanted to get out of the house.
Why?
Truth.
Sure. You're strong enough.
Let's see. My family scheme was not good. Daddy always thought that he married me.
Thank you. That's all right. Just take a minute and pull yourself together.
For her, this is together.
He's right. But anyway, I always knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to be like all those people in the movie. Only it's funny. I never wanted to be Ann Miller. I always wanted to be Doris Day. You said I have this little,
problem.
See, I really couldn't sing. I could never really sing, but I could do it.
Sing.
Glasses a day. 3 weeks.
shock, too.
Sir, who have you been with my son?
Nobody, nobody.
Then how can you have gonorrhea?
Well, I told him about the book's diagnosis for milky discharge, and he set me straight.
You know something? It's the only time the church helped me out.
Well, I will.
Mark 1:10. That's the story of my life. I remember when everybody was my size. My best friend, and everybody started holding up. And I was so dead. Mark 1:10. But I kept hoping and praying. I even had to call the parent of Mark by the hour. I'll be nice, Rich. Just an inch more. Because I was into dancing then. And I was good. And I had so much to grow up to be a real ballerina.
Right down to the bottom of my soul and my soul.
I lied about my age. So I could join ACRA, you know, the nightclub union. Cause ACRA makes $60 a week working these strip joints outside of Jersey City. I work this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I really became friendly with this stripper. Her name was Lola Latour, and her dynamic twin, Woody Ford. Well, she really dumped me. I mean, we did show her in the dressing room, and she did a lot of dressing. Anyway, she used to come and pick me up and drive me to work nights. Well, the neighbors would all be hanging outside their windows, and she'd drive up in a big, big Cadillac convertible. She was going with this
little brat. That's what this was. A little brat. And that's why I shaved your head. I'm glad I shaved your head. But then my father lost his job, so we had to leave our house, and we ran into St. Louis, Missouri. Well, it was the hardest thing from my mind to be a dancer, for my mother would embarrass me so when she couldn't pick me up at school with all those great yellow rollers in her hair, no matter how much I danced, would she say?
What are you? Shave your own mother?
Hard, really. I'd have to meet up against the desk like this. can't. I have a pain in my side. Stand up straight. We're walking down the hall and I have to walk like this. With all my books stacked up in front of me.
Yeah, I thought it was just me. I thought I was a sex maniac.
You are.
I did too. I mean, it didn't go down for 3 years. And the bus was the worst. I'd just look at a bus and bingo. And then there was the time that I was making out the backseat with Sally Ketchum. We were necking and I was feeling her boobs and feeling her boobs. After about an hour or so, she said, "Ooh, don't you want to feel anything else?" I suddenly thought to myself, "No, I don't."
Did that come as a surprise to you?
Yes, it was probably the first time I realized I was homosexual. And I got so depressed. Because I thought being gay meant being a bum all the rest of my life. And I said, "Gee, I'll never get to wear nice clothes." And I was really in the clothes. I had a pair of outfits being every
day.
Hey!
Let's get one thing straight. See, I never heard about the red shoes. I never saw the red shoes. I didn't give a fuck about the red shoes. I wanted to be a Rockette because this girl from my hometown, Luella Heiner, had actually gotten out and made it to New York, and she was a Rockette. Well, she came home when Christmas could visit, and they gave her a parade. A goddamn parade! I twirled the friggin' baton for 2 hours in the rain. Unfortunately, though, she got knocked up over Christmas. Merry Christmas! And never made it back to Radio City. That was my plan. New York, New York, here I come. Except I had one minor problem. I was ugly as sin. I mean, I was ugly, skinny, holy, unattractive, and flat as a pancake. Get the picture? So I get off this bus in my little white shoes, my little white ties, my little white dress, my little ugly face, and my long blonde hair, which was natural then. I look like a fucking nurse. I had $87 in my pocket and 7 years of tap and acrobatics. I could do a 180-degree split and come on tap in the Morse code. Well, with that kind of talent, I figured the mayor would be waiting for me at Port Authority. Wrong. I had to wait 6 months for an audition. Well, finally the big day came, and I showed up in the music hall with my red patent leather tap shoes, and I did my little tap routine, and this man says to me, "Can you do pancakes?"
step out of line. When did you start dancing, Paul?
Not so very late.
Why?
I don't know why, I just didn't.
Well, what did you do?
Nothing much.
Come on, Paul, you must have done something. How old were you when you did start dancing?
I was 16.
Well, what did you do up until the time you were 16? I mean, what was your family like?
We were close.
Close? Brothers? Sisters?
I had two sisters. One died when I was 14.
How?
I really don't want to talk about that. I mean, why do I have to talk about that?
Larry, can we please sit down?
Yeah, Zach, can the kids sit down now?
And smoke. Can the adults please smoke?
All right, everybody take a break. Out in the hall. Paul, we'll try this again later. Cassie, stay on stage, please. In the chorus?
Oh, look, Zach. I'd love a part, of course, but I'll take what I can get.
You're too good for the chorus, Cassie.
Too good? I did a couple dance parts. So what?
You were featured. You stopped two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
I can't get a job, Zach. God, you sound like all my friends, my fans, acting like I'm a star and don't know it. When the truth is, I never even came close, and nobody has the guts to tell me. Well, it would be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer. Give me somebody to dance for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to go.
So you're going through a slow period. It happens to everyone. Something will happen.
That's what I kept telling myself in California. And I kept telling myself that. Well, nothing will happen. I can't act.
What?
I can't act. And here I am in California, supposed to be this actress. Well, it didn't take me long to find out I can't act. It didn't take Hollywood very long either.
You didn't work out there.
Sure, a rotten part in a so-so film. Oh, the part ended up getting cut, thank God. I was a go-go dancer in a TV movie of the week. Let's see. Oh, yeah, commercials. I almost got to squeeze a roll of toilet paper when I lost out in the finals. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business and I end up plucking toilet paper squeezing. Oh, it was a dancing band-aid. That was fun. Oh, we had an earthquake. Hey, I got a terrific team. Oh, and Shirley, you must have heard
me. I did hear you going out with some big agent, being a bit wild, running around, carrying on.
Well, when you're a woman of leisure, what else is there to do but get a bit wild and run around? Not to mention getting fat and going crazy, which is why I came back to New York, which is why I'm here today, Zach. Oh dear, little pussycat, I need a job. To have something that I can believe in, to have someone to be. Choose me, choose me.
I just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Cassie.
Why not?
Listen, if you need some money, call my business manager.
Well, sure I need money. Who doesn't? I don't need a handout. I need a job. I need a job. I don't know any other way to say it. Do you
No.
Brian, have we got that far? Oh, look. I haven't worked in 2 years. Not really. There's nothing left for me to do, so I'm putting myself on the line. Yes, I'm putting myself on your line. I don't want to wait on tables. And what I really don't want to do is teach other people how to do what I should be doing myself.
God, I'm a dancer. A dancer, dancer.
Give me somebody to dance with. Give me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world of the living by showing me how to begin. Give me the chance to come through. I am needed, but you did not give up.
You can't go back to the chorus, Cassie. That's not the answer.
I'm not trying to go back. I'm trying to start over again. I'll settle for that. Starting over.
Starting over?
Yeah.
We can't.
What? Me? You're talking about...
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You're talking about us.
Cassie, let's just keep this business, okay?
Well, by all means. Well, who's here for anything else? That's what it's all about, isn't it? Work? Zach? Well, that's why I'm here today. About work.
But you shouldn't have come. You don't fit in. You don't dance like anybody else. You don't know how.
But I did it years before. I can do it again. Don't even let me try. Please, just give me the chance.
Excuse me. Zach, do you want the kids back now?
No. No, take the kids down to the basement and teach them to lyric that number. Oh, and send Paul in. All right. Go with Larry and learn the lyric.
Say you don't look Puerto Rican, you don't look Puerto Rican. But I am.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No. I just wanted to be somebody new. So I became Paul San Marco.
Why did you want to become someone new?
Why? I'm not exactly proud of my past.
Who is? But that's what the word means, Paul. Past.
Look, that may be easy for you to say, but everyone
can just... Look, wait a minute. What made you start dancing? Your parents?
No. But if Puerto Ricans know about theater, now they have Channel 47. Then they didn't have anything. But my father loved movies. He'd take us all the time. He worked nights, and he'd come home and take us to 42nd Street. We'd come out of one movie and go to another and another movie. I don't know why, but I loved musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street?
Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
Well, I'd have to move down front because I couldn't see. But I wear contact lenses now. Well, I'd move down front, and these strange men would come and sit beside me and play with me. I never told anyone, because I guess it didn't matter.
Why didn't it matter? Look, Paul, this is too rough for you. I have your picture and resume.
No. Okay. See, from seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around on the street. And I'd get caught all the time. God, it was embarrassing. I was always being Sid Charisse. Always. I really don't understand, because I always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I really wanted to perform. One day my cousin said to me, "You'll never be an actor." I knew she was telling me this because I was such a sissy. I mean, I was terribly effeminate. See, I always knew I was gay. And that didn't bother me. What bothered me was that I didn't know how to be a boy. You know, one day I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, you're 14 years old and you're a faggot. What are you gonna do with your life? By that time, I was at Cardinal Hayes High School. There were 3,000 boys there. I had no protection anymore. I had no homeroom where I could be charming and funny with the tough guys so they'd fight my battles for me. But I went to small schools. I liked school. The grades got so bad. Even if I knew the answers to questions, I wouldn't raise my hand because I would be afraid they would laugh at me. I mean, they'd even whistle at me in the halls. It was awful. So finally, I went down to the principal's office and I said, I am a homosexual. I mean, this was a Catholic high school. And even in 1975, when you're 15 years old, you just didn't say that. And he said, would you like to see a psychologist? And I did. And he said, I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and I think you should quit school. So I did. I really didn't want to. I just couldn't take it anymore. See, when I quit school, what I was doing was I was trying to find out who I was and how to be a man. You know, there are many people in this world that don't know how to be a man. Since then, I found out that I am one. But I was looking for the wrong thing. I mean, I was trying to find out how to be butch. So I started hanging around 72nd Street. Meeting all these really strange people. Just trying to make friends that were like me so that I could understand what it was that I was. And somebody told me they were looking for male dancers for the Jewel Box Review. We know the drag show. So I go down to audition. Now from all those years of pretending I was Sid Charisse, and I had this fabulous extension, I could turn anything, my first audition. And they said to me, well, you're too short to be a boy. How would you like to be a pony? And I said, what's that? And they said, a girl. What do I have to do? Show us your legs. I have hair on my legs. That's okay. Come on upstairs. And they brought me back downstairs and they said, oh, you have wonderful legs. And I said, really? Terrific. It's a strange thinking about all this. It was a whole lifetime ago. I was just past 16. Anyway, then there was this whole thing of me trying to hide this from my parents. That was something, because I had to buy all this stuff, like shoes for rehearsal and earrings and makeup, and I'd hide it all when my mother would find it. But I told her that there was this girl in the show, and she didn't want her mother to know what she was doing, and I was holding the stuff for her. She believed me. I was finally in show business. It was the asshole of show business, but it was a job, nothing to brag about. I had friends. You see, after a while, it got so demeaning. Nobody at the Jewel Box had any dignity. Most of them were ashamed of themselves and considered themselves freaks. I don't know. I think it was a lack of dignity that got to me, so I left. I muddled around for a while. I worked as an office boy, waiter. See, without an education, you can't get a good job. So when the Jewel Box called and asked if I'd come back, work in the Apollo Theater on 125th Street, doing
4 shows a day with the movie. It's really tapping me. When the show was going to Chicago, and my parents wanted to say goodbye, they were going to bring my luggage to the theater after the show. We were doing this big oriental number, and I looked like Anna May Wong. I mean, I had these two great big chrysanthemums on either side of my head, and this huge headdress with gold balls hanging all over it. And I was getting ready to go on for the finale, and I was going down the stairs. I wish I see women by that stage door. My parents. They got there too early. And I freaked them, I didn't know what to do. So I thought, I know. I'll just walk quickly past them like all the others and they'll never recognize me. So I took a deep breath and I started down the stairs. And just as I passed my mother, I heard her say, "Oh my God." And I had to go on for the finale, so I just kept going. After the show, I went down to my dressing room. After I finished dressing and taking my makeup off, I went back downstairs. There were my parents, standing in the middle of all of these. And the only thing they said to me was, "Please write. Make sure you eat. Take care of yourself." But just before the parents left the theater, my father, he turned to the producer and said, "Of my son." You know, it's the first time you ever called me that.
Starting position is turned in third. Hips and shoulders on the diagonal. elbows up, chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8, one, take. Four.
You know you'll never be lonely with you.
did you leave me? I came home one night and you were gone.
Why, Zach, yes. You noticed.
Very funny.
You'd already left me weeks before.
Left? I thought we were living together.
No. Sharing the same apartment, maybe. No, I mean, in the real sense of the word, left. You left when you were madly in love with him.
I wasn't. You know I wasn't. I was directing my first play.
And you were in love with him. And often the only world that means anything to you.
Cassie, you know how important that was to me. Christ, if I could direct a straight play and pull it off, it meant I wasn't going to be stuck just making up dance steps the rest of my life.
You were never going to be stuck. You were going to make sure you did it all. Direct, choreograph, musicals, plays, movies. I knew you loved work, but you really get off on it, don't you?
Yeah, I guess I do. You didn't seem to mind it when we were working together. It was only when we weren't.
Oh, Zach, I didn't mind not being a part of your work. I loved you. I could have handled that. It was not being a part of your life that really got to me. And not being able to keep up with you because that's what you were expected. I know you did. Well, you were moving up and you wanted me to be right up there with you. I was a good dancer, but you wanted me to be a star.
What's wrong with that? Why shouldn't you be? Why shouldn't you be the best you can be? When I got out of the chorus, I decided I was
not... suspicion, that's a disease. God, good, better, best, I hate it. How do you stand it?
Yeah.
Are you going to go from one show to the next, and then rehearse them all 24 hours a day for the rest of your life? You know, you're even doing this to death and trying to prove something. Like I was doing it for you to please you, to keep you, and to get you back. Well, I don't want to prove anything anymore. I just want to do what I love as long as I can and as much as I can. But at least now I'm doing it for me. Who are you doing it for?
Singular sensation.
Oh, I'm sorry, I have no right to judge.
One thrilling combination.
I mean, why are we doing this? Aren't we over this by now?
One smile and suddenly nobody else will do. I am.
Good. Then don't feel like you owe me any favors. Just treat me like everybody else.
Never do anyone for me. Do the tap combination.
Okay, everybody, it's a tap combination. Ready? A 5, 6, 7, 8. Stay on the beat.
hand back. Get a snare.
Just call a doctor.
I really don't need a doctor.
You should call a doctor.
Paul, who's your doctor?
I really don't want a doctor.
Paul, who's your doctor?
Call Dr. Sydney Rose, 595-7639.
Larry, call him.
Dr. Sydney Rose, 595-7639.
Please
try
breathing slowly
if
you'd like, Paul.
Oh, maybe you should
cross
something under his knee.
Give me a dance bag.
Yeah, I think I just twisted it.
Easy. Ready? One, two, three. Is that better?
Does anyone have Dawn or Valium?
I do.
Somebody give me some water.
I will.
You're going to be okay, Paul. Right.
Oh, my God. Oh,
my God. You too. Fine. Let's get him up. Easy. Ready? One, two, three. Where are the stands at?
Which one's
here? I'll see you later. Call me from the hospital.
What do you do when you can't dance anymore?
Kill yourself.
No, really.
Shit, what kind of question is that?
It's real heavy, yeah.
I know, but what do?
Well, I'll tell you, because I'm getting scared. I mean, I really love being in this business, but then one day it hits you. Okay, Richie, you've been having fun for almost 8 years now, and where's it getting you?
Yeah, there's a lot of people feeling that way, and they're getting out of the business fast.
There's no security in dancing.
Well, wait a second.
There's no promotion, there's no advancement.
Yeah, but you're looking for that kind of security, forget it.
It's not just that.
Well, what then?
I could deal without that, but shit, there's no work anymore.
Oh, around here, man. Isn't it happening to everybody?
Oh,
everybody.
Please, I don't want to hear about how Broadway's dying because I just got here.
Don't worry, honey, it's not.
Oh, but they're not making big musicals like they used to.
Yeah, but even if they did, and even if you get this show, it's gonna close one day. Nothing runs forever.
Yeah, but it's just the way
it is. Right.
And then you have to start all over again. Because the only chorus line you can depend on in this business is the one at unemployment.
Oh, yeah, don't you want to just dance in the chorus?
Well, gee, I just want to get in one.
Well, I want to be something besides a tall, skinny redhead, second from the end. I mean, not that I want to be a star or anything.
Hell, I do.
Who doesn't? Everybody in the whole costume country wants to be a star.
Okay. I admit it. I want to be the next Gwen Burden.
But she dances.
I know! Don't you just love her?
What I want to know is what you do when you can't dance anymore.
Well, who cares? I mean, I don't care if I never dance another step as long as I live. I'd be happy just going to Hollywood and replacing Jill St. John. Big funny deal, right? Like a dream, can't I?
Yeah, but dreams don't pay the rent.
So, I find somebody who can.
You know, that's the thing that gets me. A girl can always get married.
She didn't say anything about marriage.
And another thing is...
Please, I don't know if I can take this.
These bodies don't last forever.
I can't take it.
We're no better off than athletes.
Well, I'm sorry. I can't worry about any of that right now because I plan to go on kicking these legs as long as I can. And when I can't, I'll just have to do something else.
Right. So you get into acting.
Acting?
No, I'm serious. You'll love it. I mean, it's fabulous to find out you can talk, too. I mean, that's what I'm into. Not very good, but I am getting better. And I'll tell you something, honey. It beats busting your ass dancing any day. And at least when you're an actor, you stand a chance.
Oh, come on. There were more actors out of work than dancers.
Shit, that's Peter. Look, nobody got into this business to play a
no plans and no alternatives. Just get me through the day one day at a time is enough for me to deal with.
Listen, we all feel the same way. We wouldn't be here. But I have a wife now. Sooner or later, kids. And as much as I love dancing in the theater, it's all about paying the bills now. Getting the kids through school. I have to go where the money is.
What are you going to do?
I'd like to stay in the business. Maybe stage managing. Someday directing.
Hello.
Whatever. I'll just have to see, huh?
Well, I don't know what else I'd do.
Well, we all had to pick another career. Go on, pick a career. And what would you like to be when you grow up?
Yeah.
I know what I'm gonna do. Because I know one night, whatever show I'm in is gonna close. And I'm finally gonna be able to get off my diet. And Mark, my husband, go up to our 50 acres in Vermont with a bunch of kids, dance around my kitchen cooking, and enjoy getting fat.
That sounds good. Except the fat part. Yeah, I think I like it, but just not right away.
All I want to be is just happy.
Oh, come on. I'm too happy. I sit around and get depressed and think about all these things, too. And I meet somebody, and they say to me, wow, you dance on Broadway? Fabulous. You've got somewhere, you're something. Guys, I get this feeling inside because I remember when I used to stand outside that stage door. And I used to watch these girls come out with their eyelashes and their makeup. God, I'll never be that old. I'll never be that old. I'll never be old enough to come out of that stage door. Deep down inside, I knew I would be. God damn it, I've come this far and I'm not giving up now.
That's what I used to say. I've got to be a ballerina by the time I'm 18. Then I discovered I should be in musical comedy, so I said, okay, I'll be a chorus girl. But I got to be playing parts by the time.
You can do that too. Give yourself a time limit.
I still live.
Yeah.
And you're 25. You say just a couple of years more. Hell, I'm 30. I mean, how many years do I have left to be a chorus? Three? Four? I get my eyes done. I'm tired of dealing with on that level any longer. So just lately, I've been thinking about opening a dance studio. I don't know. Am I copping out? Am I growing up?
Well, who does? Who knows anything? It's just something you're going to have to wait and see.
Right. But if today were the day you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
If today could fall.
Thank you. terrific. You've been wonderful about going through all of this today. I sincerely wish I could hire all of you, but I can't. Will the following people please step forward? Greg? Al? Deanna? No, I'm wrong. Back in line, Deanna. Christine? Bebe? Sheila? Connie? Maggie? Front line? Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm sorry. Rehearsals begin September 22nd. We'll rehearse for 6 weeks with a 2 month out of town trial. Our New York opening will be sometime mid-January. Be prepared to sign a standard minimum contract with a 6 month writer. To be contacted sometime next week as to where and when to sign your contract. And I'm very glad we're going to be working together.